My name is Rosemary Shoko, and I'm 65 years of age. I'm just a housewife or a farmer who lives in a communal land where I grew up indigenous crops. Dramatically, my life changed with the coal mining. I can give you an insight on how we live. On the eastern side of our place, there's a mine. On the northern side of our place, there's a mine. We are surrounded by the mines. Also, there's a lot of pollution in the only resource, Deka River, where we get food like fish for consumption and reeds for making baskets to make our ends meet.
Wange is a mining town where coal has been extracted for over 100 years now. The coal is mined in mainly open pit mining, but also underground mining. And there's also an important thermal power production plant here, which produces 40% of the country's electricity. So the coal miners and processors have a impact on the environment, not only on the water, but also on the air.
So my name is Desiree Rupen. I am from Switzerland and I am a PhD candidate at ETH Zurich. The project we are working in, it's called community-based water quality monitoring for the Deka River in Hwange in Zimbabwe. So community-based means that we work with community members that live along Deka River that are impacted by the water pollution and that have already initiated a mediation process with coal miners and processors of Hwange in order to improve their environmental condition.
Sometimes we see water green, yellow, blue,
and the fish.
We find fish dead. That's why we want some boreholes in our areas, in our villages, so that we can drink good water.
The community monitoring is done now by 12 community monitors from these villages, and they sample 9 different locations. When we scientists come in from time to time, every few months, we do additional sampling that is complementing the community efforts. Our results have shown that the water in Deka River downstream of the inlet of this mining effluent channel can really not be recommended for human consumption. So as far as we have understood now, concerning human health, a main issue is manganese, for instance, and nickel, that are potentially toxic elements if they reach specific levels. And we took fish samples from fish that died during fish kills, and those fish also show very high levels of metal pollution. So for us, there is no doubt that this fish died because of the mining effluent that is entering the river system. Where science really has the potential to make a contribution to the improvement of the situation. So this motivated me very much to see you cannot resolve the problem, but you can support to find the solution. And also the fact to work with people like the community monitors, they give me a daily motivation to do my job. I hope that the community soon receive the drinking water bowls that also the coal miners and processors have agreed to.
This project provides this data and also should give, let's say, leverage for the community efforts in order to deal with the companies in this mediation process.
As a human rights defender on the environment, my motivation was to be aware of what is being done. We know that water is life to people. There's nothing we profit from the mining, only that we are just happy because there are some nationalities who are doing the mining. Our children are getting jobs there. I would like to change by negotiating with them so that we come to tables. Whenever an investor comes, if we don't lobby or if we don't advocate, the future of our children will not be good. So we keep on advocating so that the future of our children will be good.